خدا میں رضوی ہوں.
حضور حجت الاسلام is amongst the great awliya, and Allah says in the Holy Quran, لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. These are those beloved servants of Allah that neither do they fear nor do they have any grief. Means that they do not fear anything in the dunya. They are not like us, that we are afraid of every single thing that happens in this dunya. Look at how afraid each one of us is because of this virus that is taking so many lives and making so many people sick. It's human nature. We become scared of the situation. But the awliya, Allah, are those who have no fear. They only fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they do not grieve because they know whatever happens, happens by the will of Allah, and they have mazboot yaqeen in this here. And that is why, in reality, they are the close servants of Allah, because they have submitted completely in the court of Allah. Every Muslim is supposed to submit, but they have submitted to a level that you and I cannot even think and understand. So Allah tells us that they have submitted to this level, that لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون, that neither do they have any fear nor do they have any grief for anything in the dunya. They are content with whatever is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when a person becomes fully content with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he kisses the door of wilayat. He enters that door of wilayat by Allah's mercy and by Allah's grace. And by the sadaqah of Rasul Pak, Sahib al-Ula, Qadrat Ahmad al-Mustafa, Muhammad Mustafa, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And amongst these personalities is Huzur Sarkare Hujjatul Islam radiallahu an. Now, who is Huzur Hujjatul Islam? I'm sure most of you already know. But for those who do not know, I'm going to tell you very quickly. Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu an is the eldest son of Ala Hadrat Imam Ahl Sunnat Asha Imam Ahmad Raza Khan Fazile Bareilly radiallahu an. He is the eldest son of Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat loved him dearly. And Ala Hadrat radiallahu an gave a very clear and explicit message regarding Huzur Hujjatul Islam, Hadrat Hamid Raza Khan radiallahu ta'ala an. What did he say? He said, Hamidum minni wa ana min Hamid. Ala Hadrat radiallahu an said, Hamidum minni wa ana min Hamid. Hamid is from me and I am from Hamid. What does it mean? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Fatimatum minni wa ana min Fatima. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Fatima is from me and I am from Fatima. Why? Because to show that the nasl of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, will flow from Bibi Fatima al-Zahra radiallahu anhu through Sayyidina Imam Hassan and Sayyidina Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhumah. And here Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu is saying that Hamidun minni wa ana min Hamid, means that Allah had already blessed Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat with this foresight, that he knew that my generations will go from, my nasl will, my lineage will flow and spread from Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu ta'ala an. And my grand spiritual successes after my two children will come mostly from the awlad of Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu ta'ala an. And as you can see that present in the world today in the family of Ala Hadrat radiallahu an. Huzur Sayyidi Sarkare Mufti Azam Hind radiallahu an was the second son, but he did not have any male children to continue his lineage. Huzur Hazrat Anwar Raza, the young son of Huzur Mufti Azmin, passed away at a very young age, some say four years old. So he had no more sons. But the sons were from Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu an. And specifically this chain from the children went through Huzur Mufassir Azam Hind radiallahu an. And if you look at them, amongst them is who? Huzur Sayyidi Sarkare Taju Sharia radiallahu ta'ala an. So Ala Hazrat radiallahu an foreseen this then, and he said, Hamidun minni wa ana min Hamid. Hamid is from me and I am from Hamid. So this was, subhanallah, the foresight of Imam Ahle Sunnah radiallahu anhu. So this is who Huzur Hujjatul Islam is. He is that personality regarding whom his father gave this glad tidings and gave this khush khabri, that my spiritual and my physical lineage will go and will flow from Hamid Raza. It will go to the nooks and the corners of the world through Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu ta'ala an. Initially it was from Huzur Hujjatul Islam and Huzur Mufti Azam. I mean the blessings of Huzur Mufti Azam until Qiyamah. But if you look at the lineage direction, then it is from the awlad of Huzur Sayyidi Hujjatul Islam radiallahu an. And Sarkare Ala Hadrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu an did see this before. He did see this before. That is why he said, Hamidun minni wa ana min Hamid. So Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu anhu is that very blessed personality. Huzur Hujjatul Islam is that very blessed personality whom his father spoke about in this manner. And the great scholars say that he was, those who saw him, and alhamdulillah, amongst the people, while I'm on the topic, amongst the people that got to see Huzur Hujjatul Islam was who? Who is one amongst the people that is still in this dunya today that saw Huzur Sayyidi Hujjatul Islam radiallahu anhu and took his blessings as a child? Huzur Sayyidi Muhaddis Kabir, Hadrat Allama Mufti Ziyaul Mustafa Al Qadri Razvi Amjadi, the Imam of this Zamana, the Sufi of this Zamana, the Mystic and the Ghazali of this Zamana, the Grand Muhaddith of this Zamana, is amongst those people who with his eyes saw Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu anhu as a child. Hujjatul Islam had come to his home in Ghawsi Sharif to meet Huzur Sadr Sharia. And Hujjatul Islam, Huzur Muhaddis Kabir himself says, and Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu anhu asked me my name, and I told him my name, and he took his finger and he tucked it into my tummy. He even asked me what I was studying at that time. So I feel in my heart that this blessing that Huzur Muhaddis Kabir has, it is because of that dua that was given to him at that time. Huzur Hujjat Islam made dua for him as a child that he should be a grand scholar of Islam. And this is the blessing of Huzur Hujjat Islam on Huzur Muhaddis Kabir. And that is why Huzur Muhaddis Kabir became the right hand of Huzur Sayyidi Sarkare Taju Sharia radiallahu anhu. It seems as if that this companionship was secured in that time by the Nazre Karam of Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And this is food for thought. I thought I'd share this with you because we're talking about Hujjatul Islam. And if you want to see somebody that has seen Hujjatul Islam, that was touched by Huzur Hujjatul Islam, that was given dua by Huzur Hujjatul Islam, that was looked at by Huzur Hujjatul Islam, and the personality at whom Huzur Hujjatul Islam smiled and showed shafqat to as a child, then that personality is Huzur Sayyidi Sarkar Muhaddis Kabir. We make dua that Allah gives Hazrat long life and his Saya Karam may be upon us forever. But for us to understand that Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu anhu was the manifestation, Huzur Muhaddis Kabir himself says, and those who had seen, and those scholars who had seen and left the world, those pious who saw and left the world already by now, they say that Hazrat Hujjatul Islam was such a beautiful personality. He was such a very handsome personality. He was very fair in complexion and his face glowed with the radiance of Iman, Nure Iman. Anybody who saw him could not compare him to anybody else that they had seen in that time. That's how handsome he was. He was regarded as one of the most beautiful personalities in his era. This is why, and this is one of the reasons that he was called Hujjatul Islam. In other words, leave alone his knowledge, leave alone his piety, leave alone his wisdom, his face alone was the Hujjah of Islam, was the evidence and the proof of the Haqqaniyat of Islam. In other words, that his blessed face itself was the evidence of the truth of Islam. Okay, and this could be evident, and if you look at his awlad thereafter, you will see this present, and you saw it at the, those who saw Huzur Sayyidi Sarkari Taju Sharia radiallahu anhu, saw this at an even greater level, that how the tajalli and the beauty of Huzur Sayyidi Hujjatul Islam was present in the face, and in the jalwa of Huzur, and his jalwa was present in Huzur Sayyidi Sarkari Taju Sharia radiallahu anhu. So Huzur Hujjatul Islam was a very, very blessed and very beautiful personality. And then the scholars have said that he was the manifestation of Huzur Ala Hadrat in appearance. And he was also the true inheritor of his father in knowledge and wisdom. He was, the Akabirin said that he was such a personality that he was a shining example of Haqqaniyat of Islam. And he was blessed with outer beauty. People have outer beauty, but he wasn't only just beautiful from the outside. Huzur Hujjatul Islam was beautiful from inside. Okay, Almighty Allah had blessed him with an amazing outer beauty and an inner spiritual beauty as well. And whoever would see Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu anhu, they would say, and as I've said before, they would say that we have never seen anybody like this. And leave alone the Muslims. The non-Muslims, when they looked at the face of Huzur Hujjatul Islam, that they would say that this is Hujjatul Islam. Scores of non-Muslims accepted the pure religion of Islam in short moments, in just by looking at his face. Just by looking at his face, so many non-Muslims accepted Islam. And the brilliance of this husn and this handsomeness was such that anybody who saw him would say the same word, Hujjatul Islam. He is the evidence of the Haqqaniyat of Islam. And that is why till today, Hazrat Hujjatul Islam, many people may not even know that, what was his name. For those who know, they know, but many may not know. Because he became well known by Hujjatul Islam. His name is Hazrat Shah Hamid Raza Khan radiallahu anhu, Muhammad Hamid Raza Khan radiallahu anhu. But he was known as Huzur Hujjatul Islam, okay? And he was such a handsome personality, such a spiritually charged personality, such a great alim, a muhaddith, a mufakir, a mufassir, a mufti, a faqih. He was such a great personality. You must remember, he was nurtured at the feet of Sayyidi Ala Hazrat Ali Mulbarkat radiallahu an. He was nurtured by the du'as of Hazrat Naqi Ali Khan radiallahu an. So it's something that we should try to understand that what a great upbringing he was blessed with. Sarkari Hujjatul Islam radiallahu an. But with all of this, Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu an was a very, very humble personality. Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu an was a very, very humble personality. He didn't have any dikhawa. He didn't do things for the dunya, for the world. And even the scholars had so much of respect for him. When Huzur Hujjatul Islam used to travel to Haramain Tayyibain, to Makkah al-Mukarramah and Madinatul Munawwara for Hajj and Ziyarah at the court of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he met very great scholars. He met personalities like Sayyidina Shaykh Sayyid Hussain Dabbagh radiallahu anhu. He met Hazrat Sayyid Maliki Turki radiallahu anhu. But all these great scholars, when they would meet Huzur Hujjatul Islam, they would be taken aback. They were taken aback by his brilliance, by his eloquence, by his piety, by his husn. And when, leave alone all of that, he spoke, when he would speak, the scholars would say it seemed like flowers were flowing from his blessed mouth, like petals were flowing from his holy mouth. Gems of Islam would be spread from his Mubarak Zuban. And his eloquence, and his fluent, and he was so fluent, he was so eloquent and fluent, that leave alone in his own language, in the Arabic language, he was so fluent that these great scholars like Sayyidi Imam Dabbagh radiallahu anhu, etc. You know what they said? They said, from amongst the learned and the talented personalities in India, we have never met anybody who was more fluent and eloquent in the Arabic language than Hujjatul Islam, Mawlana Hamid Raza. Subhanallah. What a wonderful personality. What a Mubarak personality. Yet he was so simple. And you know how humble he was? You and I should learn humility from these beloveds of Allah. This life is very short. Arrogance will take us nowhere. We should learn from the pious servants of Allah. Do you know how humble he was? Do you know how humble he was? How much of humility Huzur Hujjatul Islam had? Such a big alim. Son of Imam Ahmad Raza. Today, somebody is the son of, without disrespect, not everybody that happens, because somebody is son of Imam Sahib, or is the son of a doctor, or is the son of a lawyer, he thinks he is the Imam Sahib. He thinks he is the doctor. He thinks he is the lawyer. And he wants to be in that level. Huh? But look at the awlad of Ala Hazrat. Look at Hujjatul Islam. Look at Huzur Mufti Azmin. How humble they were. How simple they were. The son of Ala Hazrat, Hujjatul Islam, the personality who the great ulama of Makkah and Medina showed so much of respect to. But do you know what was his humility? Do you know what was his respect towards them? Learn from the lives of the pious. Learn from these beloved servants of Allah. This is why we commemorate their urs. We commemorate the day of their wisal to honor them, so that we may attain blessings, and at the same time so that we may talk about them, and that people may understand how blessed personalities they were. And we commemorate their urs so that we may learn from their life. We may speak about them so that we may learn from them and let them be our examples, because they are no better examples than those who are drowned in the love of Allah and absorbed in the love of Allah and His beloved Rasul, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now I said to you, he was the son of Ala Hazrat. He was the grandson of Allama Naqi Ali Khan. He was the brother of Hazrat Mufti Azam. He was the murid of Sayyidina Imam Abul Husayn Ahmadain Nuri radiallahu ta'ala an. He was the father of Huzur Mufassir Azam. But he was a humble personality. He was a simple personality. You know what his humility? His humility is explained by Qutb Madina. His humility is explained by Qutb Madina, Hazrat Sayyidina Shaykh Ziyauddin Madani radiallahu an. Hazrat Ziyauddin Madani radiallahu an is the Qutb of Madina Tul Munawwara. A very exalted personality who is from amongst the Mubarak disciples and the Khulafa of Imam Ahl Sunnah radiallahu an. Very great personality, Hazrat Sayyidina Qutb Madina Shaykh Ziyauddin Madani radiallahu an. What does he say? He says that Hujjatul Islam was a very radiant and handsome personality. And he says he was such a humble man, he was such a humble person, that when I would journey from Madinatul Munawwara to Bareilly Sharif, he would be such an admirable host, such a unique host, that he would even take a cloth and personally clean my shoes. Allahu Akbar, Hujjatul Islam. Son of Ala Hadrat, brother of Mufti Azam, murid of Sarkar Abul Hussein Ahmad Nuri. That Hujjatul Islam. What is he doing? When Qutb-e Madina used to come, he would take his shoes and wipe them, he would shine them. Yet Qutb-e Madina would try to stop him. He never allowed anyone else to serve food to Qutb-e Madina. Qutb-e Madina says, he never allowed anyone else to serve me. He would personally serve my meals to me. Huzur-e Qutb-e Madina further says, he says, I have difficulty explaining and expressing the extent of his hospitality. When I would prepare to return from Madina Sharif, he would humbly say, please convey my salutations at the exalted court of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and pray that he invites me to the holy city. Although Qutb-e Madina, because at times Qutb-e Madina would not even see that he had shined his shoe, but he afterwards found out that it was Hujjatul Islam because he would be kept outside and he would do it. What is this? This is humility. This is completely finishing your nafs, that you do not desire, follow your nafs. You do what is the command of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you humble yourself. And this is what he did. How many people today would wipe the shoe of their mother or father? How many people today would pick up even the shoe of their ustad? But this was the adab that Hadrat Sayyidina Hujjatul Islam taught and the humility that he taught. And what was this humility for? One, because Huzur Sayyidina Qutb-e Madina was a great alim and a budurg of his time. But the other reason, because he came from the city of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. He was honored to wipe the shoe of a personality who walked in the city of Madinatul Munawwara, who came from the city of the beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These are the awliya. This is who Hujjatul Islam was. We can talk a lot about him, but this alone is sufficient for you to know the personality that he was, for us to learn from him on this day of his Urs Sarapa Quds. And these are the awliya. People want to ask us, why are you remembering Hujjatul Islam? Why are you remembering Huzur Mufti Azam? Why are you remembering Ghaus-e Pak? Why are you remembering Sarkar-e Khaja-e Pak? Why are you remembering Ala Hadrat? Why are you remembering Hadrat-e Badshah Peer? Why are you remembering all these pious servants of Allah? Why do you make the Urs? Why do you start doing special arrangements on the day of the Wisal? Other Muslims also die. But why are you giving so special preference to them? People don't understand that these are the chosen, the beloveds of Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if you want to understand who they are and who the awliya Allah, I'm going to present one narration to you, which Imam Jalaluddin As-Suyuti, not some third grade person, not somebody who's just taken something from his pocket. Imam Jalaluddin Suyuti is the Imam of his zamana. Imam Jalaluddin Suyuti radiallahu anhu is the treasure chest of knowledge and wisdom and ilm and hikmah. Hadrat Imam Jalaluddin Suyuti radiallahu anhu quotes in his Sharh al-Sudur a narration, and I'm going to give you the essence of that narration. Hadrat Imam talking about who these awliya, who these pious servants of Allah, why we remember them. Do you know why? Because our passing and their passing cannot be compared. Their passing is so exalted. The pious servants of Allah are blessed more than any of us can be. And we are blessed because of them. Hadrat Sayyidina Imam Jalaluddin As-Suyuti radiallahu anhu narrates a narration. And he says that Hazrat Tamim Dari radiallahu anhu said, that Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Almighty Allah says that, O Malakul Maut, O angel of death, go to my wali and bring him. For I have tested him with distress and consolation. And I have found him to be as it pleases me. So I wish to grant him relief from the distresses of the world. It is narrated in this Hadith Sharif that Malakul Maut takes with him a jama'at of 500 angels. Allahu Akbar. Going to take out the ruh of that wali, that beloved servant of Allah. The one who Allah has given closeness. Malakul Maut takes with him, this is in the Hadith Sharif, that Malakul Maut takes with him a jama'at, a congregation of 500 malaika, angels. And you know what they do? They carry with them the fragrant, the khushbudar kafan of Jannah, the shroud of Jannah. Yes, the kafan that you're putting for them here, it's the worldly kafan. But the malaika are descending with the kafan of Jannah for them. And stems with flowers from which emanate a variety of fragrances. These flowers of various colors are being brought in the hands of the malaika. For what? To come and welcome the soul of this wali of Allah. It is stated in the Hadith Sharif that they also have in their possession white heavenly silk that has been immersed in musk. And Malakul Maut then sits down with the angels near him. Each angel keeps its hands on his limbs. In other words, they keep their hands on every limb of the wali. On his hand is the hand of an angel. On his foot is the hand of an angel. On his head is the hand of an angel. On each of his limbs is the hand of an angel. Then the silken heavenly fabric immersed in musk is placed under his chin. And one of the doors towards Jannatul Firdaus, towards Holy Paradise, is opened unto him. Now the heart of the wali becomes inclined towards Jannah. He is sometimes engrossed in looking at the maidens of Jannah, sometimes towards the heavenly robes, and at times he is observing the fruits of Jannah. Just as people in a house comfort a crying child, likewise his heart is comforted. The stated narration, his heart is comforted, and his Jannati wives become pleased during this time, and his soul rejoices. The angel says, O pure soul, go towards the wonderful trees, the expanded shades, and the flowing waters, in other words, of paradise. Malakul Maut at that time shows more affection towards him than a mother would show to her child. Malakul Maut shows more affection towards him than a mother would show. And Malakul Maut knows that this soul is beloved to Allah. Malakul Maut knows that this soul is beloved to Allah. So by being gentle on the soul, he is seeking the pleasure of Allah. Who? The angel of death. The ruh of the wali leaves the body, just as a strand of hair is removed from flower. And the beloved Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam explains that here, as his soul leaves, the angel says, Salamun alaykum udkhulul jannah bima kuntum ta'amaloon. Salamun alaykum udkhulul jannata bima kuntum ta'amaloon. Peace be upon you. Enter into heaven. Enter into Jannah, which is the reward for your deeds. Allahu Akbar. This is the maqam of a wali. This is the time of the passing away of a wali. This is the fazilat that is given to a wali. Now you think about it when you ask, why should we remember Hujjatul Islam on the 17th of Jumadul Ula? Why should you remember Ghawsi Pak on the day of his urs, of his wisal? Why should you remember the other awliya on these days? Because it is on those days that the malaika come and give them so much of adab and honor. Because the malaika honor them so that they may become close in the court of Allah, so Allah may be pleased with the malaika. They are the close ones in the court of Allah. But so that they may further please Almighty Allah. The malaika come with khushbu. The malaika come with beautiful kafan from Jannah. Why? To honor the malaika, to honor the wali of Allah as he's leaving this world. So when we on the day of the urs of the awliya Allah do things to honor them, then indeed we are following in the way of the malaika. We are honoring them. And because of that, inshallah al-azim, Allah will ease our path in the akhirat as well. And this is the wali. This is the beloved of Allah. And this is why today we are remembering Hujjatul Islam radiallahu anhu. And this is why we remember all the pious servants of Allah to the best of our ability. Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu anhu lived his entire life for the sake of the deen of Allah. He stood firm for the sake of the deen of Allah. He was active in the socio-economic issues of the community. And he advised the Muslims how to live their lives properly and how to earn halal income. He taught them how to educate themselves. Huzur Hujjatul Islam was a very, very wise personality. And you would see that wisdom in his awlad, and you would see that in Huzur Siri Taj Sharia radiallahu ta'ala an. And you will see it even in Huzur Qaida Millat up to today. That blessing and that beauty and that radiance of Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu an. Huzur Hujjatul Islam was a very soft personality. Very, very soft-hearted. But when it came to deen, his firmness was shown. He never compromised when it came to any bad mazhab or deviant. And he would always give a very clear and open message regarding the enemies of Allah and his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm going to end today's discussion with a message of Huzur Hujjatul Islam. And I'm going to try and share this message in written format later on, sometime later in the day, inshallah, or maybe tomorrow, for the barakat of the urs of Huzur Hujjatul Islam. But I'm going to end today with a message of Huzur Hujjatul Islam, and with requesting once again to make dua for my beloved father, Haji Qasim Ghulam Rasool, and for all the marhums of the Ahl Sunnah, and all those that have passed away amongst the Ahl Sunnah. Dua, special dua I'm requesting for the mother of Ustaz Ahmad Sabir, who's been very ill over the last week and a half. May Allah grant her shifa kamila, siyata ajil. Special dua for brother Noshad Hamid and all our Sunni Sahihul Akida Muslim brothers and sisters that are ill, and this difficult time that people are going through, the infections of COVID, etc. May Allah grant all shifa, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the dua of Huzur Muhaddith Kabir on our behalf, which Hazrat made a few days ago, saying that all those who are ill with this, may Allah give them shifa, and those who are protected, may Allah keep them protected. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. So, to end today's discussion, the message of Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu ta'ala an. Huzur Hujjatul Islam's message, he says, Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu an says a very, very important message he gave. Few words, but a very important message. He said, because today there is this call of unity, 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 unite with the Badr Mazhabs, unite with this one, unite with that one. Unity is with Ahlu Sunnah. And those Ahlu Sunnah who are real, not those who in the front claim to be Ahlu Sunnah, and on the other hand they are doing that which is nifaq. Huzur Hujjatul Islam's message, I'm ending with, listen to the message. He said, what reason is there to try and unite? I'm reading this, I'm saying this very softly, this message. I'm presenting this message very, very, very slowly, so that it is embedded in your heart. It is embedded in your mind. I know sometimes I speak a little bit too fast, but I'm saying this very slowly, so that it is embedded in your mind and in your heart. Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu anhu said, what reason is there to try and unite with those who spend their days and nights scheming to undermine the Ahl Sunnat in order to increase the number of their deviant followers? Allahu Akbar. Listen again. His message on the day of his oath. What reason is there to try and unite with those who spend their days and nights scheming to undermine the Ahl Sunnat in order to increase the number of their deviant followers? In other words, their deviant supporters. And then he says, remember, if these deviant sects, if these firqas were on haq, then there would have been no need for them to leave the mainstream Islam and form their own firqas and their own sects. Something to think about. Few words, but very, very important message. Who are those that are still holding to mainstream? The Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah. All those that have left have come out of Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Not that the Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah came out of anywhere else. We are following the deen that was brought by the beloved Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, passed down by the Sahaba Ikram, the Tabi'in, Tabi' Tabi'in, the Amma Mujtahideen, the Awliya Ikram deen, until our Mashaykh and our Budrullah deen have given us this deen in this Zamana. So remember the words of Huzur Hujjatul Islam radiallahu anhu when he said, what reason is there to try and unite with those who spend their days and nights scheming to undermine the Ahl Sunnah in order to increase the number of the deviant followers? Remember, if these sects, these deviant sects were on haq, then there would have been no need for them to leave the mainstream, in other words Islam, and form their own firqas and their own sects. May Allah keep us with iman. May Allah let us leave this world with iman. May dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes this pandemic from the world. It is causing immense distress, especially here in South Africa with the new strain that has come in. May Allah ease this time, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove the pandemic from this dunya by His mercy as soon as Allah wills. And may Allah ta'ala keep us in His rahmah while we are here, and even if when we leave the dunya, may Allah keep us in His rahmah. Wa ma'alayna al-bilaghu. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.